Good morning. Today we are going to start a second chapter from American literature. It's a poem written by Walt Whitman. Poem is I Hear America Singing. Let us start with Walt Whitman. Who is Walt Whitman? Walt Whitman is one of the most famous American poets of the 19th century. He was born on May 31st, 1819 in West Hills, New York. He was died on March 26, 1892 in Camden, New Jersey. His published works are Leaves of Grass, Drum Tracks, Democratic Vistas. Then we are going to speak about Walt Whitman in detail. Walt Whitman is one of the most significant American writers of the 19th century, and many critics consider him the nation's greatest poet. In addition to writing poetry, Whitman worked as a journalist and volunteered in military hospitals. Considered one of America's most influential poets, Walt Whitman aimed to transcend traditional epics and eschew normal aesthetic form to mirror the potential freedom to be found in America. Walt Whitman is one of the most significant American writers of the 19th century. He was also a journalist. He volunteered in military hospitals. He was considered one of America's most influential poets. His book Leaves of Grass, which he edited and expanded over the course of his life, is a masterpiece of American literature. He published three works. Among these works, we can see that Leaves of Grass. It is a masterpiece of American literature. He himself edited and expanded over the journey of his life. Then we are going to speak about Walt Whitman's early life. Walt Whitman was born on May 31st, 1819 in the village of West Hills on Long Island, New York, approximately 50 miles east of New York City. He was the second of eight children. Whitman's father was of English descent and his mother was Dutch. In later life, he would refer to his ancestors as having been early settlers of Long Island. The second of Louisa Van Velsers and Walter Whitman's eight surviving children, he grew up in a family of modest means. While earlier, Whitman's had owned a large parcel of farmland. Much of it had been sold off by the time he was born. As a result, Whitman's father struggled through a series of attempts to recoup some of that earlier wealth as a farmer, carpenter and real estate speculator. So we can see that he was born in the village of West Hills on Long Island. He was the second of eight children. About his family, his father was of English origin, his mother was Dutch. Actually, when Whitman was born, their family was rich. After that, his father was forced to sell their farmland. As the result, his father was forced to struggle through a series of attempts to regain some of that earlier wealth as a farmer, carpenter, and real estate speculator. In 1822, when Walt was 2 years old, the Whitman family moved to Brooklyn, which was still a small town. Whitman would spend most of the next 40 years of his life in Brooklyn, which grew into a thriving city during that time. So we can see that when Whitman was just 2 years old, they shifted the place. They reached in Brooklyn. He spent almost 40 years in Brooklyn. It has started to grow as a developing city during that time. After finishing public school in Brooklyn, Whitman began working at the age of 11. He was an office boy for a law office before becoming an apprentice printer at a newspaper. In his late teens, Whitman worked for several years as a school teacher in rural Long Island. When he was just 11, he started to work after his public school in Brooklyn. He started to work as a trainee at a newspaper. After several years, he started to work as a school teacher in rural Long Island. In 1838, he founded a weekly newspaper on Long Island. He reported and wrote stories, printed the paper, and even delivered it on horseback. By the early 1840s, he had broken into professional journalism, writing articles for magazines and a newspaper in New York. I hope all of you remembered well. In addition that to write poems, he was a journalist. So we can see that in 1838, he discovered himself a weekly newspaper on Long Island. He reported and wrote stories and printed the paper, and even he delivered the newspapers by himself on horseback. Finally, in 1840, he had broken into professional journalism. He started to write articles for magazines and newspaper in New York. Whitman proved to be a volatile journalist with a sharp pen and a set of opinions that didn't always align with his bosses or his readers. He backed what some considered radical positions on women's property rights, immigration, and labor issues. He lambasted the infatuation he saw among his fellow New Yorkers with certain European ways and wasn't afraid to go after the editors of other newspapers. Not surprisingly, his job tenure was often short and had a tarnished reputation with several different newspapers. As a journalist, we can see that Whitman proved to be a volatile. He was a courageous person. He had a sharp pen and set of opinions. That's why he didn't always support with his bosses or his readers. He had his own stand. He gave moral support what considered forceful positions on women's property rights, immigration, and labor issues. He recorded his opinions without favoring the masters. So he criticized the infatuation he saw among his fellow New Yorkers and also European ways. He was not at all afraid to go after the editors of other newspapers. That's why I told you he had his own stand. So his job term was often very short. He had a blackened reputation with several different newspapers. That's why he didn't make a good impression on him. As the result, he always enlisted in a blacklist as a journalist. He had his own strong views. He was ready to oppose the injustice. He didn't want to favor any masters. As the result, he couldn't continue the job as journalist in any newspapers for long. We are going to speak about his early writings. Early writing efforts by Whitman were fairly conventional. He wrote about popular trends and contributed sketches about city life. So we can see that Whitman's writing efforts were traditional. He wrote about popular trends and also contributed sketches about city life through his works. In 1842, he wrote the temperance novel Franklin Evans, which depicted the horrors of alcoholism. In later life, Whitman would denounce the novel as rot, but at the time it was a commercial success. His novel Franklin Evans, it depicted the horrors of alcoholism. He wrote this novel in 1842. Whitman would criticize the novel as rot. He didn't have a good impression about his own novel, Franklin Evans. But at that time, this novel was a commercial success. In the mid-1840s, Whitman became the editor of the Brooklyn Daily Eagle, but his political views, which were aligned with the upstart Free Soil Party, eventually got him fired. In the mid of 1840s, he started to work as an editor in Brooklyn Daily Eagle. But unfortunately, he couldn't continue the job as editor in Brooklyn Daily Eagle for a long because of his political views. He then took a job working at a newspaper in New Orleans. While he seemed to enjoy the exotic nature of the city, he was apparently homesick for Brooklyn. The job only lasted a few months. Later, he started to work in another newspaper. It is New Orleans. Even he started to enjoy the unnaturalized nature of the city, but he was homesick for Brooklyn. As the result, he was forced to stop the job in New Orleans. By 1853, Walt Whitman was still writing for newspapers and just starting to write poetry. By the early 1850s, he was still writing for newspapers, but his focus had turned to poetry. He often jotted down notes for poems inspired by the busy city life around him. In 1853, still he was continuing the job in newspaper. At the same time, he started to write poetry. In early 1850s, he was still writing for newspapers, but at that time, he started to focus in writing poetry. He started to write quickly notes for poems. His poems were inspired by the busy city life around him. Then we are going to speak about his very famous work, Leaves of Grass, in detail. I already told you Leaves of Grass is a masterpiece of American literature. In 1855, Whitman published the first edition of Leaves of Grass. The book was unusual as the 12 poems it included were untitled and were set in type that looked more like prose than poetry. So we can see that Walt Whitman published his first edition of the poem Leaves of Grass in 1855. The book was unusual. There were 12 poems in this first edition, but he didn't give title for these 12 poems. More than that, these poems look like prose than poetry. Whitman had written a lengthy and remarkable preface, essentially introducing himself as an American bard. For the frontispiece, he selected an engraving of himself dressed as a common worker. The green covers of the book were embossed with the title Leaves of Grass. Curiously, the title page of the book, perhaps because of an oversight, did not contain the author's name. The frontispiece for the first edition of Leaves of Grass shows Whitman dressed as a rural worker. Another speciality of his work, Leaves of Grass, it had a lengthy and remarkable preface. He is introducing himself as an American bard through his poem. Bard means skilled in composing and reciting verses. Then we are going to speak about the front page of the book Leaves of Grass. The frontispiece, he selected an engraving of himself dressed as a common worker. He designed the front page of that book Leaves of Grass. He was cutting grass as a common worker. He also gave the green color to that book, but we can't see author's name in the frontispiece. The poems in the original edition were inspired by the things Whitman found fascinating: the crowds of New York, the modern inventions the public marveled over, politics of the 1850s. While Whitman apparently hoped to become the poet of the common man, his book went largely unnoticed. Then we can see that the first edition of this book, Leaves of Grass, was attracted by the crowds of New York. So Whitman hoped that he would become the poet of the common man, but his book went largely unnoticed. However, Leaves of Grass did attract one major fan. Whitman admired the writer and speaker Ralph Waldo Emerson and sent him a copy of his book. Emerson read it, was greatly impressed, and wrote a letter to Whitman, "I greet you at the beginning of a great career." Walt Whitman was a great fan of Ralph Waldo Emerson. Who is Ralph Waldo Emerson? He is an American essayist, lecturer, philosopher, and a poet. So Walt Whitman sent a copy of Leaves of Grass to Ralph Waldo Emerson. Then he also wished Whitman, "I greet you at the beginning of a great career." Whitman produced approximately 800 copies of the first edition of Leaves of Grass, and the following year he published a second edition which contained 20 additional poems. So we can see that after the first edition of Leaves of Grass, he published a second edition. In that second edition, he also added 20 additional poems. Whitman saw Leaves of Grass as his life's work. Rather than publishing new books of poems, he began a practice of revising the poems in the book and adding new ones in successive editions. So we can see that he considered Leaves of Grass is part of his life. That's why he started to revise the editions. When he revised the editions, at that time he also added more poems. The third edition of the book was issued by a Boston publishing house, Thayer and Eldridge. Whitman traveled to Boston to spend 3 months in 1860 preparing the book, which contained more than 400 pages of poetry. Some of the poems in the 1860 edition referred to homosexuality, and while the poems were not explicit, they were nonetheless controversial. So we can see that the third edition, the book was issued by a Boston publishing house. To publish this book, he spent 3 months in Boston in 1860. That edition contained more than 400 pages of poetry. He also spoke about homosexuality through this edition. When he published this third edition, it became controversial. Then I want to speak about Civil War, how it affects the life of Walt Whitman. In 1861, during the beginning of the Civil War, Whitman's brother George enlisted in a New York infantry regiment. In December 1862, Walt, believing his brother may have been wounded at the Battle of Fredericksburg, traveled to the front in Virginia. The proximity to the war, to soldiers, and especially to the wounded had a profound effect on Whitman. He became deeply interested in helping the wounded and began volunteering in military hospitals in Washington. That's why Whitman started to serve for the wounded in military hospitals in Washington. He visits with the wounded soldiers would inspire a number of Civil War poems, which he would eventually collect in a book called Drum Taps. So we can see that his experiences relating the military hospitals in Washington, he wrote a poem and he published the poem as Drum Taps. As he traveled around Washington, Whitman would often see Abraham Lincoln passing by in his carriage. He had a deep respect for Lincoln and attended the president's second inauguration on March 4, 1865. Walt Whitman attended and wrote about President Lincoln's second inauguration in 1865. Whitman wrote about the inauguration, which was published in the New York Times on Sunday, March 12, 1865. Walt Whitman had a great respect for Lincoln. In addition to that, he also got the opportunity to see Abraham Lincoln passing by in his carriage. As the result, he wrote about President's second inauguration in 1865. It was published in the New York Times on Sunday on March 12, 1865. In his dispatch, Whitman noted, as others had, that the day had been stormy up until noon. When Lincoln was scheduled to take the oath of office for the second time. But Whitman added a poetic touch, nothing that a peculiar cloud had appeared over Lincoln that day. As the president came out on the Capitol portico, a curious little white cloud, the only one in that part of the sky, appeared like a hovering bird right over him. When we go through the article he wrote about Abraham Lincoln, we can see these lines. Actually, when Lincoln speaks, we can see a white little cloud. It is in that part of the sky, appeared like a hovering bird. And he also reveals that the day had been stormy up until noon. Whitman saw significance in the odd weather and speculated that it was a profound omen of some sort. Within weeks, Lincoln would be dead, killed by an assassin. While Whitman gave importance to that atmosphere and he wrote about the bad weather, he also felt it's a signal of some sort. Then we can see that after weeks, Lincoln was murdered. By the end of Civil War, Whitman had found a comfortable job working as a clerk in a government office in Washington. That came to an end when the newly installed Secretary of the Interior, James Harlan, discovered that his office employed the author of Leaves of Grass. After the Civil War, he started to work as a clerk in government office in Washington. He was very comfortable as a clerk. But unfortunately, he couldn't continue the job as a clerk because of James Harlan. He discovered that he was the author of Leaves of Grass. With the intercession of friends, Whitman got another federal job, this time serving as a clerk in the Department of Justice. He remained in government work until 1874, when ill health led him to resign. After that, with the help of his friends, he got another job as a clerk in Department of Justice. He was very happy there, but because of his ill health, he was forced to resign his job in 1874. Whitman's problems with Harlan actually may have helped him in the long run, as some critics came to his defense. As later editions of Leaves of Grass appeared, Whitman became known as America's good prey poet. Then we are going to speak about Whitman's death. Plagued by health problems, Whitman moved to Camden, New Jersey in the mid-1870s. When he died on March 26, 1892, the news of his death was widely reported. The San Francisco Call, in an obituary published on the front page of the March 27, 1892 paper. So we can see that he died on March 26, 1892. After his death, the San Francisco Call published an obituary on the front page on March 27, 1892. Whitman was buried in a tomb of his own design in Harley Cemetery in Camden, New Jersey. Whitman's poetry was revolutionary both in subject and style. Though considered eccentric and controversial, he eventually became known as America's good gray poet. When he died in 1892 at the age of 72, his death was front page news across America. Whitman is now celebrated as one of the country's greatest poets, and selections from the Leaves of Grass are widely taught in schools and universities. Walt Whitman was an American poet whose verse collection, Leaves of Grass, is a landmark in the history of American literature. Despite the previous outcry surrounding his work, Whitman is considered one of America's most groundbreaking poets. So all of you, please go through the page number 5 in your textbook. It's an introduction about Walt Whitman. We already discussed all the major points relating Walt Whitman. We will start the poem I Hear America Singing, written by Walt Whitman, in our next class. Thank you.